Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm writing a book on One God, One Faith, and this is chapter 22, and I'm writing the summary. This is video number 3, and in total video number 34. So, this is a big lecture. Chapter, so it's well to be well explained, and this is just a gist of the what I have written. The whole thing may take quite a big space. So here is a summary, and the fate of such tares. You know the parable of wheat and tares, Matthew 13 verse 24 to 30. The farmer sowed good seed. Farmer is Yahweh. He sowed good seed. And then Satan came in and came, sowed his own seed, sons of Satan, which are the tares. The fate of such tares is as per Matthew 13 verse 24 to 30. He put another parable before them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is what you see with your two-eyed naked eye. The royal kingdom of God, you can't see it inside your heart. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to a man, Yahweh, Brahma, or Khudah in Arabic, etc., who sowed good seed in his field. World at large. But while this his men, that means his men are Rabbi, Pandits, or as John the Baptist was, Prophet Elijah. Elijah means my God is Yahweh. So that was his men, whose while his men, Rabbi, Pandits, etc., sitting in the seat of Yahweh, were sleeping, that means spiritually blind, as in this dark age. His enemies, sons of Satan, the devils, who make people religious outwardly of appearance and not of heart. A Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. When a Jew becomes outwardly, then he breaks the covenant with Abraham or with the Semitic race. Because Jew is a spiritual self, it has no color, nothing. So you break the covenant with Abraham and then you become unfaithful to Abraham or sons of Satan. Came, so the enemy, his enemy came and sowed weeds, sons of Most High Satan, Al-Djmar, Al-Aksa, the super bastard fanatic devils, John 8 verse 44. When Jesus was sitting in the temple, he told the Jews that your forefathers are super bastard fanatic devils, and they took stones to kill him, you know, but he dodged. Among the wheat plant and went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds, tares, appeared also. These weeds are appearing today in abundance. In India, Pakistan, they are all becoming Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian of the appearances, and they are their own tribal identity, they are giving it away, are replacing it with Sikh, Muslim, Hindu and Sikh. So they become tares, you know. And the servants, angels, such as John the Baptist and Stephen was angel, you know, of Yahweh, who was first martyr. in Stephen, he was an angel of Yahweh. So the servants of the master Yahweh of the house synagogue came and said to him, Master, Lord Yahweh is Lord. Our Father is not Lord. Our Father is Father. If you call him Lord, then you become a slave. And slaves are not allowed into the house. So you keep your Father Emmanuel. Father is inside me, not outside. Me and my Father are one. Master, Lord Yahweh, he is one who is in the heaven, you know, that is the Father of Jesus, Yeshua. Yeah, from Yahweh, Shua means Adam. Did you not sow good seed in your field, in the word, sons of Adam? How then does it have weeds? He said to them, an enemy has done this. Enemy is of the sons of man is sons of Satan. As in recently, President, ex-President Morsi, you know, of Egypt, he became the sons of the most high Satan, Al-Djmar, Al-Aksa, when he started a Muslim Brotherhood. What Muslim Brotherhood have to do with physical self? It is spiritual self. So he was the latest sons of Satan, you know, and Egyptian did well, but they put him in the jail, you know. So as an enemy has done this, so the servant angels said to him, angels are those who are perfect in the moral laws. Then, do you want us to go and gather them? Let me uproot them, you know. But he said, no, lest in gathering the weeds, you root up the wheat along with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. And at harvest time, I will tell the reapers, gather the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burned. Now, these are bundled up in Israel, you know, the Jews. They are the Jews outwardly, not of the heart. They are unfaithful to their own tribal father and also to Abraham and Yahweh. So they are the tares getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. And so they have created these other tares also, like Muslim Christians of outside. When they become Muslim Christian of the appearance, then they say bye-bye to their tribal father, or they become sons of the Satan, Most High Satan, Al-Djmar Al-Aqsa, as Morsi was creating. So then you suffer sectarian riots. So it is happening in the Middle East. And when it will happen in India, India more light, stronger fanaticism, or more stronger in the sons of Satan. So when it will happen in India, the sectarian riots shall be far worse than anywhere else could be imagined. So they will be very, very bad, you know. So in this dark age, everyone has to give his own account to God. So you have to be solitary if you want salvation. And if you are not solitary, then you are just following somebody. You are a blind man. Only blind follow others. One who has the eye, he doesn't follow anyone. He is solitary. So I gave you this, the proof of this wheat plant and tares. During the partition of India in 1947, the people became Hindu, Sikh, Muslim of physical self. which we call Kaum, our tribe. Then my father told them, you know, you have formed a new tribe. Now you should be looking for new homes also. You can't live in your tribal home, because that home belonged to the tribe, not to the Hindu, Sikh or Muslim. So same thing happened. The tribal father kicked them out, get lost. And when they went to the Sikh temple or Hindu temple or over there, Nanak said, you know, you are not faithful to your own tribal father. How could you be faithful to me? You did not obey the first will. How will you obey the second? And he kicked them out too. So that is why they have to leave the country. Partition, movement of the people. And same is happening now in Middle East. People are going towards the West, you know, for refuge, because they have become unfaithful to their tribal fathers. If they remained faithful to their tribal father, they could stay in their country and live peacefully. The people of the Middle East, they are not so fanatic. Those Mohammedan, they just told them to give them in writing that they will obey their rules and Islamic law. While in India, no writing. They just kill. So you can see that how the trend will vary, you know, from East, highly fanatic, Middle East, less fanatic, West, no fanaticism. So this is a end of the world, and there's a tribulations period going on. In 2018, when Israel is 70 years old, then tribulation will be on the top, great, and that will bring the atomic war too. Because after 70 years old, Israel has no protection. They have created their own enemies, because circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac and his seed only, not to the Gentile. But the Jews were making the sons of Abraham through circumcision. What happened was this: the people of Judah tribe were so clever, you know, that they, in religious also ceremonies, other things, they occupied the church, occupied the temple in Jerusalem. After occupying it, then they changed the name of the religion, Judaism, because Judah people were predominant. They became Judaism, and from Judaism they became Jew. And then they were putting their shawl and other things and sitting there. So people who came to visit as pilgrim to the temple, when they will see them, hey, how they look nice, you know, with the shawl and all that. Let's become one of them. So they will ask the rabbi, how can they join you? And then he will tell them, you have to be circumcised, you have to do this thing, that thing, rituals, and all that they were telling them. And they were circumcising Gentile. That was Stephen told them, don't make fake sons of Abraham. Abraham was a noble man, and be noble. Don't go for money and cheating. And they killed him. And those very fake sons of Abraham circumcised Iranian, Pakistan, India. They are now their bloodthirsty. They are a staunch enemy. So they created them. So they have to face it. You, in this dark age, you can't blame a third party. Whatever you do, so shall you reap very soon. And they are going to reap it now. And our Father God blesses you.